I definitely felt like in grad school when my experiments didn't work for like years and, you know, I didn't get awards that I had applied for or things like that. I felt like the failure was like me as a person. I failed as a person. And so like, I think for me, like the depression was like not being able to like, to square that, you know, not being able to understand that like science is a whole lot of failure, like just a whole lot of failure. Like so many things that you try are not gonna work. And how do you keep going?
First, eat right, sleep enough throughout the day, and exercise. Those are essential.
Something that really helps me is staying physically active. So I notice that whenever I'm feeling really, really down, a lot of times I can feel quite a bit better if I can just make myself, you know, get moving.
Sometimes I deal with being sad by really throwing myself into science and just ignoring it completely. And I don't know if that's healthy, but I like that I have that option. But sometimes I deal with it in like healthier ways, right? Like I call a friend, I talk about it, I do yoga, I like bring myself to a different place and then able to sort of deal with it more.
About halfway through grad school, I started meditating and man, it changed my life. I think taking moments to reflect and sort of one, calmly be present, but two, sort of reflect on the good in your life. And you know, what helps me some of the most is thinking about people that I care about and those people being present in my life.
So one thing I did with varying success was to establish work-life balance and find things that had nothing to do with grad school that I could occupy my time with.
Get separated from your work frequently. Make sure you don't get yourself too overwhelmed. You have time to get this stuff done. You have people there to support you. And no matter what, you'll get through it, no matter how low you feel.
The next thing I would do is don't isolate yourself. Reach out to people who care about you or who you trust, whether it's a committee member, a friend.
For me, it really helped to have a strong community of other graduate students. So when I was feeling down, I needed a night off, hanging out with those friends who were in the same lab or in the same program and knew what I was going through was incredible.
I frequently sought out the help of older graduate students. They're going through it. Some of them have been through those emotional highs and lows that you're going through. And so talking to older graduate students or postdocs or faculty that have all been through this is a really great way to combat those periods of emotional lows.
When I feel I am not doing good, I ask for help. It could be I ask for help from my friends, from family members, or when I really need it, I ask for help from a professional.
Talk to a professional. It is so valuable, and seeing a therapist is definitely intimidating if you haven't already, but you will find someone who can help you.
Most universities also have counselors that you can go to talk to about depression. They're invaluable, they're professionals, so they're always great sources of knowledge and guidance.
And I'm very glad that at most universities, at least in the US, we have the resources. We have counselors. We have people who we can go and talk to, and they are going to help us to get better.
So it runs the gamut. I feel like your mid to late 20s, right, is a period where you're just throwing a bunch of things at the wall and seeing what sticks.
There's never going to be a time where it's like there's literally nothing else to accomplish. There will always be another paper to work on, an article to read, an experiment to brainstorm.
It's important for you to be the best version of yourself. In any capacity, whether it's in science or any other field.